Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, we will solve problem 14 and 15 of miscellaneous exercises chapter 12 of 11th class maths. Okay. Let us read the main question here. Find the derivative of the following functions. It is to be understood that A, B, C, D, P, Q, R and S are fixed non-zero constants and M and N are integers. Right. So we have to find the derivative of the given function here. In the 14th problem, the given function is sine x plus a. We have to find the derivative of sine x plus a. Right. So since we have to find the derivative, we have to start with d by dx. So d by dx of sine x plus a. Now we have not found the derivative of such functions, right? You know the derivative of sine x, but you don't know the derivative of sine x plus a. So what we have to do here is use the formula of sine x plus y. So you have studied this formula in trigonometric function in 11th class only. So sine x plus y is equal to sine x cos y plus cos x sin y, right? This you have studied in trigonometric function chapter. So let us use this formula here. Since now it is sin x plus a, according to the formula we will get sin x cos a plus cos x sin a. And we have the derivative here, so d by dx of this expression, okay. So this will be equal to, now by algebra of derivative, you can split the derivative for both the terms here. So we will get d by dx of sin x cos a plus derivative of cos x sin a. Now see, here we have sin x cos a, so a constant which is cos a is multiplied to sin x. See, since a is a constant, cos of that constant is also a constant. This you have to understand. So cos a will be out times derivative of sin x plus, again you can see here that sin a is a constant, so it will come out of the derivative. Sin a times derivative of cos x. So this will be equal to cos a. Now derivative of sin x you know, it is cos x plus sin a, and derivative of cos x also you know, it is minus sin x. So what we will get here is, we will rearrange the term. Okay, to get a formula, let us see, cos x, cos a, and minus sin will come out here, minus sin x sin a. Okay, and if you observe this expression, it is a formula. So which formula it is? It is nothing but cos x plus y formula, right? Cos x plus y is equal to cos x cos y minus sin x sin y. So you can see that we are getting the right hand side of the formula, so we have to equate it to the left hand side, and it is nothing but cos of x plus a, and this is the answer. Okay, now let us go to the next problem, which is problem 15 here. So problem 15 is cos x x cot x. We have to find the derivative of this. So d by dx of cos x cot x. Right? This function is nothing but a product of two functions. Okay? One function is cos x, another is cot x. So product of two functions it is. So whenever you have to find the derivative of a product function, we have to use the product rule here, right? And product rule is nothing but uv, the whole derivative, right? Product uv, the whole derivative, is equal to derivative of u times v plus u times derivative of v. So according to this, what we will get is, if you look at this as u and this as v, we will get derivative of cosec x, derivative of cosec x times cot x. Now you can see here that I have not put any bracket, so this will mean that it is derivative again product, right? So for that, to show that the derivative is only for this function, we have to put a square bracket here, right? So square bracket derivative cosec x. Now this will mean that derivative is only for the function cosec x, right? Then into cot x plus, now you have the function u, which is cosec x, times derivative of v. So d by dx of cot x. Now here you don't need a bracket, right? This you can understand, it is derivative of cot x only. So this will be equal to derivative of cosec x. You have studied it earlier, it is minus cosec x cot x times this cot x is also there, plus cosec x times derivative of cos derivative of cot x. It is nothing but minus cosec x square, minus cosec square x. So this will be equal to minus, this is cosec x, cot x times cot x is nothing but cot square x, and this minus sign which is there here, it will come out, right? And so if you multiply cosec x times cosec square x, you will get cosec cube x, and this is the answer of problem 15. So that's it in the video. If you have liked my video, please hit the like button. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.